I saw the girl sneeze. This is kind of. It's kind of like eating oatmeal for breakfast versus the full enchilada. You know what I mean? It's plain. So it's cute-ish. It could have been better. Their love story is merely based on. Musical dancing thing, and I want to see it again now. You know, after I studied filmmaking, I have a different perspective on film. For example, I never liked horror or anything related to gory or whatever. I still don't like gory horror, but I now like horrors because I appreciate. Have seen and recommend, please let me know. I will happily add it to my list. See, like, this one is obviously foreign. It's probably either Arabian or Turkish or French. We're getting all kinds of foreign recommendations on Netflix. Share an Armenian. Very bold and strong figure. I love her. I'm not a fan of anything other than that. And I do love old movies. I saw The Artist and I found it really cute. I just love old movies. And I know, yeah, there's a little bit of dancing and singing in that one. But yeah, not jarring. Do you guys like old movies? One of my favorite old movies is, I think it's called White Christmas. Hold on, let me check, see what it's called. I think it's with Sinatra. This has been sitting on my list for so long. I so want to see The Irishman. Yeah, really, really want to see The Irishman. I watched The Crown with my mom. sit down if I have time at the end of the day and watch maybe an episode before I knock out, you know. I'm not like a sit all day kind of blah 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 with the control. I'd rather feel like I'm doing something productive, even if it's sitting and writing a screenplay, but at least I'm doing something. Okay, so I heard this was a big fail. Hilarious. Have you guys seen Rat Race? I also find Home Alone movies cute. They're comedic. I also find what is that one with Jim Carrey? You know, where he farts and lights up his fart. Dumb and Dumber. Yeah, Dumb and Dumber Part 1. Nobody wants to acknowledge Part 2. Yeah, Part 1. Like, after those movies, I just... Oh, and there's also the Pink Panther movies. I love the Pink Panther movies. I started watching House of Cards. Family recommended it to me, and have not finished it. So, yeah, they're just, you know, it's hard to make a funny movie. If I ever wanted to do a funny movie, I'll wait until after I'm established. Yeah, I was quite shocking and saddened by the death of Black Panther's lead actor. Can't think of his name. Shocking, just shocking. I really, really love him. He's such an amazing actor, such a great movie, and I heard that they were no longer going to make any more Black Panther movies because of, you know, respect for him. Okay, let's see. Searching for their missing archaeology professor. Why would you search for your professor? and so she looks a little bit better there. But she is so beautiful. What is her name? Nadine Nishim. I heard that she was somehow involved in the explosion. I think she had surgery on her ankle or something. So this is the actress I was telling you about, who would work for my film, but she's a little bit old. Like, I would love for her to be the lead actress. She's a Lebanese actress, and this is where I found out that she had some surgery. Skin flaws with no makeup pictures. That's a typical Lebanese thing. We don't care. She sometimes wears contact lenses, making her eyes the different light colors. And I think this is one of the pictures where she has contact lenses and just a cooking show, like how to make something. Sorry.